there?
Unused space.
Oh, okay.
So basically there is no floor up there,
mm-hmm.
but we hope it's some point to get to use it and maybe have like a like extended storage up there and the robot that can get stuff for you, mm-hmm. and an elevator and things. But yeah, that's not gonna happen anytime soon.
Okay.
Yeah.
And in we go.
So the first thing is like the limbo.
Mm-hmm.
Hackerspace, where everything that is on its way into the hackerspace or out of the hackerspace is stored.
Mm-hmm.
And basically it's somebody needs some stuff, like some wires or something like that, then you can go and grab it here and nobody will mind. And the same, this is where like all donations to the hackerspace go.
Mm.
And if somebody finds something that they think should be thrown out, then this is also where it goes. So it's a giant mess at some point in time, and other times we try to take some of it to the recycling station.
Right.
Yeah. So other than that, we have like a whiteboard and some information screens that display various forms of information.
Mm-hmm. What's this one displaying?
This one is displaying the website, and I think that one is showing like the most recent, or at least one. No, this is an old blog post.
Mm. Okay. So, do we
so
go left or right?
We have a couple of toilets that are really interesting, and then we have the large common area where there's currently an open source mine.
Mm-hmm.
But this is also where where people sit and hack.
Mm.
And this is where one guy is building a laser cutter, a laser saw at the moment. And this is also the room where we have the 3D printers.
Mm-hmm.
And a cozy corner where you can sit and relax.
Okay. Cozy corner.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay. The in a so
this is all
good
about the cabinets for member storage.
Right.
So every paying member can have a locker,
mm-hmm.
for their things. And yeah, some people lock it and other people don't. It's
wine explorer.
It's normally okay. So then we have like the kitchen area where one can make food,
okay.
coffee, and buy soda and sometimes beer. It's quite nice. Sometimes people offer to cook dinner some evening, and you can sign up for that. Yeah.
Dinner. Okay.
So. This is also where we have some of the laboratory rooms,
mm-hmm.
so most prominently the electronics lab,
yeah.
which is, well, sort of well equipped. There is like power supplies and oscilloscopes and things like that. We inherited some gear from the university at some point,
mm-hmm.
And now we have been buying our own, so a couple of nice power supplies and a Rigel scope. It's of course hacked. And in general we try to keep like a well supplied electronics lab such that we have like all the different resistors one might find a use for, and some members spent quite some time organizing resistors at one point in time. So basically this is all the components are basically free.
These?
I think these are like pictures from NASA.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know who brought them. Somebody did.
Okay. Someone's inspired by space travel.
Yeah.
And there's a camera too.
Yeah, there are, we have surveillance of most of the hackerspace is on when nobody's here.
Okay.
So if somebody comes and steals something, we have pictures.
Does it stream the video anywhere?
I don't know actually. I haven't been part of setting it up. So
okay.
It does something.
I know the hackerspace in Singapore, they stream theirs.
I don't think so. These are only turned on when nobody's here.
Right.
So.
Okay.
The other room which we passed is the storage room,
mm-hmm.
which is more for long term storage, basically.
Long term storage.
Yes. So all the stuff that somebody at some point has decided is worth keeping
mm-hmm.
gets organized in here. Organized, quote unquote.
Right.
So basically, all the stuff in here is still HackAway, which is part of our labeling system.
Mm-hmm.
So you are allowed to use it for whatever you want, or to hack it for parts or destroy it. And if somebody has something that they allow other people to use, then it can be like use allowed, or the last level is hands off, which basically means that you're not allowed to touch it.
Where did you get this centrifuge?
I think we got it as a donation.
Oh.
And I'm not sure if anybody, I think it's somebody checked that it works, but nobody really knows what to do with it. So it ended up in the storage because it's just too good to throw away.
Mm.
So. Maybe somebody will find a good use for it at some point.
Mm-hmm.
I hope so.
It's really cool, like a piece of vintage equipment.
Yeah.
Mm. Oh. Okay.
Okay. Some more toilets,
mm-hmm.
and then the chemistry lab. So basically, this is just a room where we have put in ventilation,
mm-hmm.
so of different kinds, so like general ventilation and also for sucking out at different points.
Mm.
Ooh, this is some nasty stuff. Okay.
What is this?
I think it's something smoothing of some 3D prints.
Mm-hmm.
But, it's PLA, so it's lots of nice chemicals.
We have
and then
hood here.
One member is restoring some old compressor air compressors.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So the last part of the hackerspace is where all the heavy machinery goes.
Mm-hmm.
So we quite recently did a reorganization of our workshop part. So right now the idea is that in this room we have all the woodworking tools. So we have our old bandsaw, and we have our wood planer, and our drill press and so forth. So that we can keep like the wood dust more or less in this room. It doesn't work perfectly, but this is at least the theory. So we also have like storage for some larger things like these old wheelchair wheels. Which
wheelchair wheels?
Yeah. So this is we have one of them which is attached to a PlayStation controller, so you can try around with it. But in general, if you can get them to work, they're quite nice because they have all the mechanics for driving around.
Mm.
I mean, other than that, we have a few workbenches in different states.
Different states.
Yes. So one member is working quite actively on restoring these old air compressor, so he's working on them quite often. So we also try to have screws and nuts and bolts and stuff like that in reasonable quantities. Trying to keep things sort of organized, which is an ongoing struggle. So the next room is a room that is also under construction or under reorganization.
Okay.
So this is basically the woodworking, or sorry, the metalworking part, where until quite recently we only had a small lathe and a small milling machine. But quite recently we got a old Danish lathe, which some members have been restoring and have it almost completely apart and oiled and cleaned all the small parts. And right now it's getting restored and getting some new safety features such that it is a bit more safe to use. This is also a continuing project that sort of got a little bit out of hand, because at some point we also needed a crane for changing the chucks and things. So it'll be very nice when it's done, but it's taking a little while. And until then we have our small lathe, which is okay for plastic and very soft metals, but it'll be nice to have something that is a bit more robust.
Oh, looks like this place is on its way.
Yes, I think so. Suddenly it will be operational, I think.
So this one was donated?
No, we bought it.
Okay.
Used. So it's an old Danish brand.
Okay.
But it was it was bought. So the last room is the CNC room slash networking place. So we have all the electronics and switches in here. So when we initially moved into these facilities, some members spent quite some time and dragging networking cables all over the place. So this is very nice.
Right.
Because in all the rooms we basically have a number of networking ports that are just available. But other than that, in this room we have the CNC machine. So this is an old it's basically an old industrial CNC machine that originally could only do printed circuit boards. But we have modified it to run Linux CNC such that it can do much more. Yeah, and it can still do CNC or still do PCBs. So that's nice. But I think that was more or less the tour of the workshop.
Thank you.
Yeah.
All right. Cool. Really good.